My name is Jan Verbeek and I work as a researcher for the Dutch FA.
My name is Jorg van den Breggen. I work also for the Dutch FA as a football developer at the football department.
Yeah, it is.
Idag har vi träffat ett par representanter från Holländska fotbollsförbundet. Så jobbar med det som de benämner som grassroots, som egentligen är all verksamhet utöver landslagsverksamheterna som de har. De har tagit kontakt med oss, jag tror, i ett försök att hitta influenser utifrån deras egna verksamhet, så att säga, för att utveckla sig själva. Och de har sett AIK som en klubb som gör intressanta saker.
Team, the attacking team, they have the ball. Their aim, their goal is to score a goal.
Yeah.
Vi har haft egentligen både praktik och teori egentligen med dem. Det vill säga vi har suttit här på möten. De har fått presentera för oss vad de gör och hur de ser på dynamiken mellan ett förbund i Holland och sen då klubbar i Holland. På samma sätt, vi blir en klubb här och vi har en dynamik gentemot våra förbund. Så det finns alltid vad ska man säga, en viss antingen friktion eller dynamik beroende på hur man ser det, beroende på en utvecklingsavdelning i ett förbund och hur en enskild klubb vill göra saker. Och det är ganska intressant att se hur det fungerar i andra länder från ett förbundsperspektiv, i det här fallet med Holländska fotbollsförbundet.
Things that happens in media obviously influences the whole.
The fact that we are here these couple of days, I think it's because AIK has an interesting perspective on how to develop players. They started, or actually they stopped selecting players from the age of underage up until the under 12s a couple of years ago. And that's something we like to know more about.
The most interesting bit is that we think that every player gets the same equal opportunity. And that's one thing we also would like to see in the Netherlands. So there are several clubs who already has got the idea and trying to do that. And one of the other reasons why we came here is to see probably a good example, a good practice also literally in practice already.
The fact that you select players also means that you deselect another group of players. In practice that often means that those players don't get the equal opportunities the selected players get, which we think at least is not a good development.
No, and it starts from the under eight. So under six, under seven, usually they play all together. They have all the same trainer coaches, but then the under eight starts, and then the real, like you could say, the smaller adult world starts. So we have to put them in teams, and those teams have to be selected on maybe your talent right now. But that's not fair. They all have a different starting point. My kids probably started 2 years earlier, or they can train every day on the pitch outside. Or so it's not fair to select from that age and treat them different from that age.
Idag, Harvey.
Det vi vet idag är exempelvis att välja ut ett gäng unga killar eller tjejer vid åldern 8, 9, 10 eller något sånt där, och att man då är lyckosam i matcher har ingen korrelation eller relation överhuvudtaget med hur bra man blir som seniorspelare. Och i ungdomsfotbollen för AIKs del så handlar det väldigt mycket om lärande och utveckling. För ska vi få fram skickliga spelare till våra seniorlag och till elitfotbollen så vill det till att de på vägen utvecklas som människor. De lär sig kommunicera, de lär sig empati, de lär sig tyda kroppsspråk. Och med den grunden så blir man också en väldigt bra fotbollsspelare, eftersom att fotboll till sin natur handlar om samarbete. Och då tror vi att om vi inte selekterar och om vi justerar lite hur vi tar oss an det både pedagogiskt och strukturellt, så tror vi att vi ger barnen en bättre resa en längre tid och att vi får fram bättre spelare.
We actually saw it in practice. So we went to training. We spoke to coaches. We spoke to parents, and saw the decision Aika made to stop selecting children. We saw it in practice, and that's the most valuable thing for us, because there's sometimes a lot of skepticism to, yeah, okay, you stop selecting players, but in the end we need teams, and there are only a certain amount of players eligible to play in a team. So how would you do that? Well, and here we've seen it in practice, based on a, in our opinion, a very sound theoretical framework.
One of the other things that I found very interesting was the argumentation, their philosophy. Why did they choose for this model? The well-being of the child is one of them. The United Nations right of the child, that's the second one. And of course, in a club, it's also important that you get players from your academy in your first team. So that's the third one.
It doesn't matter if you're a big, tall guy, very small. Every player was active during the training sessions. Every player was motivated to put the best effort in. Everybody was competing. Sometimes you hear that, yeah, fun and competition don't go well together, but well, I think yesterday was a great example that it could be that it could go very well together. Parents we spoke on the sidelines mentioned that players, that their children had fun,
love to come to training sessions.
Yeah.
Enjoyed it.
It's also, I think, what's a strong part of Aika that it's very regionally based. So it's for the people of Solna. It's one of the biggest, at least we were told, one of the biggest clubs in Sweden, with a high amount of supporters from Stockholm. So that was something that you could see back on the field in some way.
När det finns ett intresse om AIK ungdomsfotboll så tar ju vi emot med öppna armar och vill jättegärna berätta vad vi gör. Och så bonus av det är ju också att vi knyter kontakter och liksom nätverket blir bara större och större och man får mer och mer influenser och kanske mer vatten på sin kvarn att man gör saker bra, men också kanske saker där man ser att det här behöver vi titta på. Och liksom, ju mer influenser man får, desto rikare blir man ju och desto klokare beslut.
If you come here at IK, you have to pump up the balls. That's if you want to
doesn't matter at which level you have been a coach, but it every time starts with pumping up the balls before the training session.
Yeah.
But that's the same thing in the Netherlands, so.
Yeah.